so. Really? Yeah, we did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I had to tighten the plan. Yeah, I got it right in the end. Now we on top, top once again. I don't want it if it ain't love. If it ain't get it away from me. Who you gon' jack if it ain't us? LABB to the bakery. Some mad that I came up. I know my granny gon' pray for me. It was just us in the vacancy. We had to get it from A to B. Wheels never felt like this. Two seats in the hills, how I feel righteous. Blue sheets for the mills, but the deal priceless. New keys can't care what's built private. I might just double it up, did it. Never enough, I'm with it. 5-2-3 on the business, whole team got wins. And the wheels still spinning, I told them. What I told them. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah, hey. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top. Got a spot and it's locked to the click all in. I got ops, if he drop, I just hit my dance. I was popped, they just watched, had to take my wins. They wouldn't let me in. I've been on 10-10 cents. Who really holding it down? I've been holding it down and I go it again and again. Who was the dummy to doubt? I'm the coldest around, but he folding again and again. I'm in the what? I'm in the day. I'm doing 30 on 30 and up. You in the what? You in the way. Either you rolling or rolling the dust. You with us or what?
Keep it running.
We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top, top once again. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on 10, 10, 10.
We are about 10 miles or so southwest of downtown Los Angeles at SoFi Stadium in Inglewood.
Today, we're set for a good AFC matchup between the Indianapolis Colts and the Los Angeles Chargers.
Time one set to kick off.
22 men ready to do battle. It's time to dance. And we are underway in Southern California. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. On first down. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
Try to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. Officially nothing on that one. No gain, so they're left with still 10 to go on third down.
Third down.
From the gun, Rivers. And he is going to have a Colts first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards.
A play fake to Mack. Now Rivers.
And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
Throwing again, Rivers on second and 10. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked by Kenneth Murray, and they'll set up shop in enemy territory at the 45-yard line.
That right there is the inauspicious start that they were hoping to avoid, the turnover on the first possession.
I love how you use those college-bound words like that, inauspicious. Well done. I really appreciate that. But here's the thing for me. I'm just wondering if their game plan is incorrect. You know, I think they felt like they could come in and throw it around pretty well. That interception early, they may rethink how they go about attacking.
First 18 big yards on that one, and a Charger first. Here's the first carry for Austin Ekeler. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. 8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple.
8 yards on the pickup brings up second and 2 at the Colts' 19-yard line.
Herbert will give this one to Ekeler. And he stopped immediately there.
The ball carrier brought down right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. Makes it.
They'll try to pick up the first with Ekeler. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. He needed 2, he got 1, and that's going to leave him with 4th down and a yard.
Brings up 4th down and 1.
On 4th down, Herbert. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he takes it in for a Charger touchdown. Touchdown, Brown. And the Chargers have taken a first quarter lead.
Lining up for the extra point.
It took a pretty big risk right there, going for it on 4th down. But, hey, not only did they get the first down, forget about that, they got in the end zone.
Yeah, because normally you're just thinking, can I get enough yardage to get it past the sticks and pick up a first down? Instead, they go for the end zone and get it done with no margin for error. Remember, 4th down, they went for it.
So an onside kick fail in the first quarter. Not sure I completely see the logic there.
It's not apparent, is it? You almost have to go deeper, I think, and maybe if we try and work along with them and speculate a little bit here, they must feel like they need to steal possessions in this game, and maybe they don't match up possession for possession with the opposite team. They've got to steal it and try and gain an advantage, and they tried. They just didn't get it done.
They'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. A big chunk on the ground there, 27 yards.
Indianapolis.
3 tight ends in the ball game here on 1st and 10. They'll run it. It's Mack. And a short gain here, down to the 22. And brought down there by a pair of Chargers on the stop. We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Just got that playoff. Now Rivers. And this one is incomplete. Zach Pascal, the intended receiver. And it's 3rd down.
Quarterbacking 101. Never force the ball into double coverage. Especially not this close to the goal line. The windows are so tight, you just don't want to force it in there because it could be tipped up and picked off.
After an incomplete pass on 2nd down, that'll leave him trying to convert on 3rd and 9. They go play action. Rivers. A good throw here, finding Pascal. And he takes this one in for a Colts touchdown. A 22-yard touchdown grab. And the Colts are an extra point away from tying up this football game. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7.
Rigoberto Sanchez.
So all even at seven now as they kick it away. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get it down at about the 17-yard line.
At their own 17-yard line.
The Charger drive about to get going. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete. He was looking for his tight end, Hunter Henry. And now it's second down. Him with third and nine looming. This defense tightening up a bit. That last catch just 1 yard, making it third and nine. Now Herbert with it, looking to pass. Eventually he's taken down here. Great coverage downfield, resulting in a sack. The linebacker Darius Leonard applied the heat. Here's Ty Long now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. That's pulled in at the 32. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And the Colts will go on offense here, first and 10.
43-yard line.
The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. The last possession, these guys were able to tie the game with a touchdown. Now they'll have a chance to move out in front.
Yeah, let's give a big assist to the defense who got the ball back. The special teams went out there, handled things. They got it. They've got momentum. I know they're eager to get out there and put it on display.
They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Brings up second and 11 at the 42-yard line.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. These two teams all tied after one.
The score tied 7-7.
Second and 11 now. Rivers, that's complete to Hines out of the backfield. It's an 8-yard pickup, and all of a sudden here, it's third down.
Oh, I came to my feet on that one. I thought he was getting close to breaking that one big, but in the end, give some credit to the defense, finding a way to get to him and forcing a third down.
Second down pass play got him 8 yards. Now they've got a third and a couple remaining. Now from the 50. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked by Kenneth Murray. And his guys are going to take over at their own 48-yard line.
And that's now the second time he's picked off a pass here in the first half alone. Again, another great read defensively, and you just see him get in the right position to make the play and get his guys the football back.
After the turnover, here's Herbert being chased out left. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but they make them out of bounds. That does you no good.
Draw play. It's Eckler. Going to get this pretty close to a first down at the Colts 43-yard line. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
A gain of 9 brings up third and one.
Herbert wants to throw it on third and one. The ball popped in the air and intercepted. Picked off by Darius Leonard, the linebacker. And to the 40-yard line, that's where the return stops. They brought the house that time on the young rookie, maybe a little rattled through the pick.
And you have to be prepared for a lot of pressure as a rookie quarterback because most defensive coordinators are going to test you that way. So when you see that, the ball's got to get out of your hands quickly, and that means your receivers have to understand they have to break off their routes quickly as well.
Interception here, Rivers. That's into the hands of Pascal. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down.
You can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. And this is going to be incomplete. Defensively, Charles, they continue to really limit this offense as far as yardage goes.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper leverage, and communicating well, too.
And now on third down, they'll need to get it to the 36 to pick up the first. Working out of the gun, Rivers. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked by Nick Vigil. The 30, the 20, 10. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six and a Charger TD. Short throw pick six right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
Extra point by Badgley, up and good. And that makes the score 14-7.
Time on, set to kick off.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. And following the pick six, and they've decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this run.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help them a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back
in. But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
Rivers to throw this time. They'll find Hines out of the backfield. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. The linebacker.
And he takes this one in for a Colts touchdown. A 13-yard touchdown run. And the Colts are an extra point away from tying up this football game. A strong, determined run there, Charles, to get in for 6 points.
This is why it's such a team game, isn't it? And I know that sounds really generic and it sounds almost trite, but the blocks were made up front, offensive line, collective victory at the line of scrimmage and downfield. And how about the finish to the run all the way into the end zone?
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Charger drive about to get going. They start from scratch here, so to speak. 14 all following the interception last time that led to a score. Now they've got it first and 10. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35 line. 1:57 to go in this first half on EA Sports. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. A shotgun snap for Herbert. Eluding the pressure right. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield.
That one good for 26 and a first down. Flushed out right. They'll get this to Eckler. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. A lot of effort there for just a 3-yard gain, and now second down. To the air again, Herbert. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. He's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. A first down there on a pickup of 25. They'll run out of the gun with Eckler. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12.
Darius Leonard on
the Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. This will be caught at about the 6. Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. Here's the 7th play of this drive. This is 3rd and 4. And they'll try and run the option to pick it up. And he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first. Chargers going to use their 3rd and final timeout as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half.
Michael Badgley for the Charger field goal. A 19-yard attempt.
Badgley able to knock this one through, and the Chargers grab themselves a 3-0 lead. Well, the drive ends in just 3, but they'll take it. Looks like they'll head to the locker room, barring something unfortunate, in front on the scoreboard.
Yeah, they may not be jumping up and down and celebrating because they have the lead, but still, any little momentum in a game like this is important to a team, and they'll feel real good about going in and regrouping, knowing that they are out in front.
The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. They'll keep it on the ground again here. And he'll push forward here for a good little run as the clock continues to run. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. An extra defensive back on the field for the Chargers now on third down. He sets to fire deep. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Nasir Adderley. And he will be brought down as time is now run out on this first half of action. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL. On EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three.
Rigoberto Sanchez to kick off for Indianapolis.
So the Chargers will start the second half with the lead and the football as we're underway in the third quarter. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And we will not see a return to start the half as this will be a touchback. The Charger drive about to get going. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put 6 on the board. That's a consolation prize. Like going to the county fair, you don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line.
Nico Autry on the stop. A gain of 4. It's now 2nd and 6. At the 4.
Here's Herbert now on 2nd down. And boy, that one drops incomplete. But if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble.
When defenses get to the quarterback that quickly, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball. And as he tried to do that, he was hit and it forced an incompletion.
Chargers first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. Herbert with a connection to Allen for a Charger first down. That throw into the arms of Allen. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. They'll contain him to just 4. 2nd down.
4 yards on the pickup. 2nd and 6.
Herbert back to the air. And he'll be brought down by the Colts. It was Justin Houston, the native of Statesboro, Georgia, with a sack.
On the play. Brings up 3rd down.
Off the play fake to Eckler, it's Herbert. Catch it on the left sideline, but they're going to roll him out of bounds. So it'll be incomplete, certainly one they'd like to have back as it brings up 4th down. This offense converted once on 4th down earlier. Now they're out there again to try once more. Doesn't work for the Chargers. And this defense is going to get the football back near midfield, right at the 48. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Nick Vigil coming in hard there on the blitz, and he gets gets him 7 yards behind the line of scrimmage.
So if we recount real quick, he had the touchdown earlier, and now he comes up with the sack here. No doubt about it, he's having himself a game.
Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Another try after the first down sack. Rivers, they'll try and set up the screen to Hines. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. Give him 9 yards on the second down screen play.
Third down.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. This is caught inside the 15. Touchdown, Indianapolis.
Number 13,
T.Y. Hilton. 50 yards. And the Colts are going to jump back in front. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions, and I'd hear 9 from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the 9, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
It's up and good to make it 21-17.
Makes the score Colts 21, Chargers 17. Rigoberto Sanchez to kick.
Sanchez now, he'll kick it away following the touchdown. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25.
5 yard line.
The Charger drive about to get going. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
How many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius. Understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball. And puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
He's going to look for Allen now. The deep ball. And coverage intercepted. Going to go to a top target like that often. That time, though, maybe a little telegraphed.
And that's not unusual because you do tend to lock in on one of your better players, and when under duress, when in doubt, you're going to throw the ball in his direction because oftentimes you could be wrong, but that receiver will make you right. But it won't happen every time. Good defenders know this, and they get attracted to the football.
And he'll find a little space. He gets this up near the 10.
Derwin James.
In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
And they see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up.
And it's third down.
A play fake to Mack. Now Rivers throws this from right side to Pascal. And he is going to have a Colts first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Back now at SoFi Stadium in Inglewood. It's the Colts. They've got control of the football. They also have the lead as we start the fourth. So a little breathing room now. First and 10 at the 17. From the shotgun, it's Rivers. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That it's complete. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
Indianapolis.
Now it's Hines. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
All right, that's a decent game there, but it hasn't been his best game overall. So I wonder what the mindset is of his team. Do they want him to handle the football and try and close this game out? Or are they going to make an alternative plan and maybe go in a different direction?
I think they need him, and this is his time to shine. And he'll get this up to about the 38-yard line. A 3-yard pickup on second and 4. Now they'll need to convert here on third and a little more than a yard.
And it's third down.
Rivers. They'll run the screen with Mack. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. But you're going to turn things around in a game like this, Charles. Those are the kind of plays that you need.
And I just love the way that defense rallied to the football on that one. They got the completion, but he was smothered behind the line of scrimmage. And when you make tackles like that, your whole defense is going to be fired up. Really nice play getting to the ball.
They'll run for it. It's Mack. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. A solid pickup of 5 and a very solid fourth down conversion. And defensively, pure frustration. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Now a carry for Mack. Going to bowl his way forward to the 48. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
I know the game's not over, but there's got to be a sense of satisfaction right now for the guy carrying the football a bunch today. 99 yards, and he has enough time to go over this entry point.
You got to give it to him again, right?
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. You're not worried about losing yardage here. You're not worried about any of that. You just want to get him to the promised land for every runner, 100 yards or more in a game.
2 yards. And it's third down.
So the Colts in possession of the football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. They'll try and run for this with Mack. Well, they hit him in the backfield and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done. A loss of 1 yard and it brings up 4. Frank Reich, he didn't even seem hesitant about this. He wants to go for it on 4th down. Rivers to throw. And that is incomplete. The Colts unable to convert here on 4th down. And this defense will take over right at midfield. Chargers in good field position to start out. 1st and 10, right at the 50-yard line. They'll run here with Eckler. Solid run on 1st down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
He was taken down by DeForest Buckner. It's a gain of 7. Brings up 2nd and 3. At the
Herbert.
42-yard line.
And that's into the hands of Eckler. And now he lost the football. But this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. You can almost see inside his face mask there the look of relief. He coughed it up, but it goes out of bounds. They keep it.
Someone carrying around a lucky horseshoe, aren't they? If I were him, I'd go out and play the lottery after that one. A very fortunate man.
And they're operating in plus territory here. They're thinking points. Definitely don't want to lose the football at this juncture. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's 1st and 10. He's back to throw. Finds the open man. It's Mike Williams. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield.
He was taken down by DeForest Buckner. Brought down back at the 24 yard.
Back to throw. And this is caught. Touchdown. And they've taken the lead here in the final minute.
How many people watching this one right here gave up? Because that score, they might want to try and rush back into this stadium.
What looks like is going to be the game deciding score, although a little bit of time left, so you can't count your chickens before they hatch.
Well, they better come back in here and watch this one, because you and I, we're not going anywhere. We want to see this one play out.
The Colts take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Come to the line ready to start their next drive. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or left, now you get a decision. Are you in field goal range, or is it Hail Mary time? Because from 7 seconds down, you don't...
He can't get a throw. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
Well, they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. Rivers. And incomplete as the clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining.
Incomplete. Kenneth Murray on the coverage.
On that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Rivers. He's going to let it fly. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked up by Casey Hayward. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going. And still two timeouts defensively, but even if they choose to use those, three kneel downs should be enough to get out of here with a victory.
And that's exactly what's being stated into the head coach's headset. Oftentimes they have a guy upstairs who monitors this at the end of the game. They'll clock management 101.
First and 10 at the 40-yard line.
Herbert off of play action. He's going to loft this one deep left sideline. Man, it's caught inside the 10. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. So this one's over. It's in the win column for the L.A. Chargers. And they were spurred on by a strong performance in that fourth quarter as they held their opponents off the scoreboard.
Everyone wants to pitch a shutout for the entire game, but when you throw one in the fourth quarter, that tells everyone that you're getting stronger and dominance is starting to take over, right? The way that you close, the way that you finish, that gets preached to you from the time you're playing Little League football all the way up through. And they closed them out with a big-time performance down the stretch.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. So long, everybody.
Bust down, but my wrist, time to talk a lot of yeah. I got both my girls head to toe designer. Drip, little bit, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit, little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. West LA, that where you find me though. Cha cha macha with a rocking black clothes. Whip around that Batmobile, ducking 5-0. If you step to me, then be prepared for smoke, little bro. Let me feel myself a little bit, let me blow this down a little bit. Drip, little bit, little bit, let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit, little bit, you ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit.
South to the cat. So many cats. I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this.
This is the NFL on EA Sports, and we are in the Pacific Northwest at Lumen Field in Seattle, Washington. These folks love their football in Seattle. This was the scene a moment ago as the home squad came out of the tunnel, and it was just absolutely deafening in this building. They're set for football, so are we, as the Seahawks get set to match up with the Kansas City Chiefs. Takes this about 5 yards deep, and he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25. State alum Chris Carson, and not much to speak of, call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26.
Gain brings up second and 9 at the 26 yard line.
On second down now, it's Carson.
A quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers playing with their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play action them or stick something to them between the second and the third level.
And he is going to have a Seahawks first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Excellent play there on third down. Give him 25 yards. And now here's a deep shot that's complete. And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. Hey! DK Metcalf, 50 yards. And the Seahawks have taken a first quarter lead. Well, that's how they envisioned it, get the football to start the game and score.
And I don't know if that was scripted. Was it an audible? Or was it just a play call that they had in their pocket? No matter what, they had the right call on against the right defense, and they end up in the end zone.
And this will give the Seahawks a 7-0 lead.
Makes the score Seahawks 7, Chiefs nothing. Jason Myers to kick off for Seattle.
After the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Mahomes going to throw. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it. And it took the ball off course.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they were able to get in there and influence the throw. And remember, quarterbacks got to get rid of it. They don't have the tuck rule that they can fall back on anymore.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Throwing now is Mahomes. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit. Even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
Throwing is Mahomes on third. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started, and that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty, and before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
Three straight incompletions. They don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. They do go for it. It's Mahomes into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by DJ Lee. And the return here is stopped at the 35-yard line.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
From the shotgun, Wilson. That's going to be caught. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the one. It's a gain of 34.
First and goal at the 1 yard line.
And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. Russell Wilson keeping it himself from a yard out. And the Seahawks find a way to stretch their lead. He hit him earlier in this first quarter with his arm. Now he does it with his legs.
Right now, he's one of those stat stuffers that you see on the basketball court. You know, the guy with points, rebounds, assists, steals. One with the arm, one with the legs. Let's see if he can continue this pace.
And sending out the reminder that, yeah, look, I'm known for having an arm, but I can do it with the legs on occasion when I need to. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. They've been outplayed early, no question. Down 14-0 already as they come up first and 10. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
Not the kind of gain that we'll go absolutely crazy for, but it's the kind of gain that you need to have when you're running back in the NFL and Clyde Edwards-Helaire with that low center of gravity and strength. He's going to get those tough, gritty yards for you when necessary.
Second and 7, Mahomes, and that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Another incompletion there. That's 5 in a row now to start this game. He's got to take a deep breath now, step back, shake it off a little bit, trust his offensive line, and hope that his play caller dials up something that can give him a completion and get him going.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give him 15 yards on that one. Kansas City has a first down.
First down, Chiefs.
From the gun, it's Mahomes. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
Well, the gap man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
Mahomes will try again on second down. A screen to Bell. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. Call that a loss of 5 yards on the play. And they're going to be staring at a third and long here. Up 5. after the delay, they're backed up even further for third and long. Again, they'll throw with Mahomes. And going deep for Hill. A 50-50 ball here, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Quadre Diggs. First quarter, and now he already has two interceptions.
Yeah, he's got to guard against being tentative from this point forward, though. He's got to still make the right reads, make the proper throws. I've seen guys in this league throw four interceptions in a game and win. He's got to understand, put it behind you, keep pressing forward.
They'll start out on the ground with Carson. And he'll get two, maybe three, up near the 37.
Ben Neiman on the...
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a game considering the blitz that they just had against them.
57 yard line.
56. Mike, 56. Right there, right there. 56. Hey, check, check.
On second and seven, Wilson. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down. They head to the line facing a third and seven following the incompletion on second down. Wilson, flush to his right, and getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. It's a gain of 12, first down Seahawks.
First and 10 at the 49-yard line.
And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. Give him 10 yards on the pickup. So now first and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 41. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. On first down, Wilson. And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. They run it with Carson. And they only get a yard back there. They'll be left with a third down and long.
Jones on the stop. Brings up third down.
Now Wilson. And he finds a man. It's Olsen. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. How about that? They weather the storm of a third and 17 to pick up the first. Throwing now, Wilson on first down. They'll run the screen with Carson. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down about the 21 or 22.
Complete.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
To throw again on second down. Wilson. And this one's incomplete. Will Disley, the intended receiver, at his third and short.
I didn't like the look of that play right from the beginning. I thought he should have seen the coverage that was there. Tried to force it in. That one, he's fortunate, just fell incomplete.
Third and two, now Wilson. And he's got Lockett. And he is going to have a Seahawks first down. It's a gain of six that time on third and two. Wilson to Lockett there for the Seahawks first down. Escaping the pressure right. Over the middle and into the hands of his receiver Moore. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. They'll contain him to just four. Second down. Wilson slings this out to Metcalf.
No gain that time on the completion, and it'll be third down.
That was impressive to me because while it was a pass play, they still rallied to the football like they were filling running lanes, and they were able to put the receiver on the ground.
Debo. Mike, 56, right there, 56. We own it.
On third down, Wilson. Left side complete to Lockett. The completion there winds up a wash, and it'll bring up fourth down.
But the stats that matter on this play don't help a team very much unless, of course, you're playing defense.
If you're getting points per reception, you got a reception, but no yardage. Great job by the defense, though. They read through that one.
They read through it, gave up no yardage, and people got credit for tackles. Pretty good deal.
So they get the field goal, but that was a 14-play drive to get three.
It's not like you're going negative.
I was.
Sounds like you're thinking the three is just not that good.
And people say that we're negative sometimes. So.
Well, here's the deal. Getting the three is good. Obviously, you would think on a 14-play drive you're going to get six out of it. But that type of a drive can pay dividends later on because you might wear the defense down.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Chiefs' offense about set to begin this drive. To this point, the results have not been good. Two possessions, two turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball. Try and get things settled down a little bit.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Complete, the tight end, Kelsey. Past the 20, and all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Travis Kelsey, 75 yards, and the Chiefs strike quickly here for 6 points. I don't think you can get any more efficient or tidy, whatever word you want to use, than that. Man, one play, 75 yards, end zone.
Yeah, efficient, tidy, excellent words. How about explosive? 75 yards, one play. That means everyone handled their assignment, doesn't it? It doesn't just mean that the defense broke down. They really executed the way that was drawn up on the whiteboard. Big time play, big time result.
Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And last time they were able to churn some clock. They got the field goal, added onto their lead. But that was a drive that was so long, it should have ended in a touchdown. You know that's how they felt.
And we'll both be headed to the airport after the game. But we probably should go to the post-game press conference because someone's going to ask the head coach about this drive. And he's going to profess that he was happy to get points. And we know that's not true.
Yeah.
Okay, after this type of a drive, not getting a touchdown, a huge disappointment.
They'll throw on first down with Wilson. His throw incomplete. Greg Olsen was the intended target, but it'll be second down.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Second and 10 now, Wilson. Airing it out for Olsen. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Bashaun Breeland. 1:54 left on the clock here in quarter number two. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Brings up second and 11.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11.
Now a throw for the all-pro Kelce is complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards.
And a first down, Chiefs.
Shotgun snap to Mahomes. That's caught. It's DeMarcus Robinson. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. Mahomes now on first down. And an incomplete pass. That'll stop the clock here with just under a minute to play in half number one. So line of scrimmage, still the 39 on second and 10. Mahomes to throw once more. And going deep for Hill. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10.
Complete.
That one goes for 30 yards. Obviously, they're not where they want to be right now on the scoreboard. Big plays like that, though, that'll trend them in the right direction.
Yeah, a few more like that, they'll be right back in the game. And if they can continue to do that, maybe they'll inspire their defense as well and get a few stops.
They'll run to Edwards-Helaire. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. Only a yard that time, second and goal. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. I'm coming after them, put the pressure on them.
The Chiefs will use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half. Six plays got them down here. This is play number 7, third and goal. Throw just what Seattle was hoping for. The coverage holds, and now fourth down.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs, able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense an unexpected fourth down here.
Butker's kick here is good, and they're back within a touchdown. It's 17-10. So the 3 points here, they're still down, but they put somewhat of a dent into that lead going into the break.
Anything helps when you're trying to chip away at a lead, but they do know that they're going to need a little bit better effort in the second half.
And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee, and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And the Chiefs are going to get him. The Mississippi State man, Chris Jones, with a sack there. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. Got to assume this defense will be charging again here. It's second and 15. Wilson after the play fake to Carson. That'll be incomplete with 9 seconds now showing on the clock. David Moore, the intended target, third down here.
Brings up third down and 15.
Off the play fake. Here's Wilson. Now he's flushed out left. Throwing left side, it's complete. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down, two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Okay, coach, appreciate it. A one touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. It'll be the Chiefs football to begin quarter number 3, and they trail here as we are back underway now on EA Sports. The The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week in our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those in their back pocket, don't they?
You have to, and if you don't keep abreast of what you're doing, you lock into a rhythm and make it easy for the opposition.
Looking for tendency breakers right now. 25 yards there on the catch and run. So from Seahawk territory now, it's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Mahomes complete to his tight end. It's Kelce. And he's got this down to the 35. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Working from the gun, Mahomes. Toward the right sideline, but it's incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Mahomes again here on second and 10. Well, Mahomes can't get away, and down he goes. Carlos Dunlap, the Florida Gator, chopping his way to the quarterback.
Enough takes to start to have a good drive, quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
On third and long, it's Mahomes. That one complete to Hill. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. Third and 19, no problem as they're able to convert.
First down, Kansas City.
Throwing on first down is Mahomes. And that is caught for the touchdown, Kansas City. Le'Veon Bell there to make the grab. And the Chiefs are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Well, he wasn't the guy they were initially going for, but after going through the progressions, it worked.
When you have plenty of people who can catch the football, you don't always have to go to your primary target, and sometimes that target is actually covered. Nice job coming off of that and getting it to someone who was open.
Yeah, the man out of the backfield gets in for the score.
Harrison Butker to kick off for Kansas City.
So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
The Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. Here's a handoff to Carson to begin the drive. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. 15 yards is the pick up there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down.
First and 10 at the 37-yard line.
Now Wilson. And he's taken down, a Chiefs sack.
Russell Wilson.
Tano Passanio. He's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of 9. To try again after the sack. Wilson, he lets it fly for Lockett. And that's caught inside the 35. 39 yards there, a big one. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30.
First and 10 at the 33-yard line.
Wilson. He'll find Ballore out of the backfield. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. The catch and run there, good for 16 and a first.
That's good for another 16.
They run the counter.
Carson.
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Brings up second and 11 at the 18-yard line.
On second and 11 now. Wilson eluding the pressure right. This will be caught just inside the 10. And he's got this inside the 10 to the 9 before he's out of bounds. He's been quiet today in the passing game, just his second catch.
Yeah, and people have to come up with schemes to limit him. And what a lot of teams do, they'll double him, you know, use a linebacker underneath, a safety over the top. Sometimes they'll just take a corner, maybe their third corner, who's a bigger guy, and put him on a man-to-man to try and limit his touches. Just keep mixing it up, give him different angles, different looks, like a good boxer does.
They're able to convert on third down, and that sets, and he will take this one in for the Seattle touchdown. A 3-yard touchdown run, and the Seahawks have taken the lead. People always talk about one of his biggest strengths running the football, vision, and he found the spot there, went into the end zone.
You're exactly right about that. It wasn't just the vision, right? Once he saw the gap, decisiveness, made up his mind, and about the power to finish the play. Not only did he get good blocking, he created his own space as well.
And he's got it up and through. And they will not have time to get another play in here as time has run out on this third quarter. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Jason Myers to kick off for Seattle.
Here's Myers now to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And now after the touchdown a moment ago, they work from behind in a 7-point game in this fourth quarter. Plenty of time on the clock. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
2nd and 3 at the 32-yard line.
They fake the give. Now Mahomes. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
He certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Yards to go.
Mahomes looks to throw on third down. He is going to find Hill here. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Well, they only needed a small gain on third down. They end up getting over 30 yards. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Now a carry for Edwards-Helaire. And he'll be taken down at the 33, a pickup of about 4.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
To throw on 2nd and 6. Mahomes, oh, he's going to let this go for the end zone. And that's going to be too high, out of bounds and incomplete. Sammy Watkins, the intended receiver. And now it's 3rd down.
And 6 yards to go.
Gun, it's Mahomes, and that will be incomplete.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
1 score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on 4th down. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. Facing a fourth down, they come away with 18 yards and the first down conversion. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Operating from the red zone now, Mahomes completes it to Hardman. And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. A 15-yard touchdown grab. And the Chiefs are an extra point away from tying up this football game.
I know these wide receivers are about flash and dash and high-flying plays, but a good number of them played running back at some point in their career, and that's how they finish off a lot of their big plays, run after the catch.
And this time he finishes off the big play in the end zone. Nothing separating these two sides. 24 all our score as he sends this one away. Taken about 7 yards deep. And this will come out to the 25 as Reed opts for the touchback.
25-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Well, they just gave up the score to tie it. That's the bad news. The good news, plenty of time in this fourth quarter to try to grab that lead back. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34.
A gain of 9.
They stay on the ground. Again, it's Carson. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down.
For us Seahawks.
From the shotgun, Wilson. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down.
So much for the best laid plans and best designed plays. That was good coverage along the sidelines. No place for that one to get in there. It sails incomplete.
Flushed out right. He's going to take off with it. The ball comes out, and it's picked up by the Chiefs.
Well, so much for the four-minute offense. They were trying to reduce the clock, get in position to win the game, and leave no time for them to come back and catch them. And guess what? They turned the ball over.
Yeah,
I mean, they had it all set up for themselves, and they let it get away.
So they recover their own fumble. Now they face third and short.
53 is the mark. 53. Check 53.
Yeah, let's get set. Lunch.
Alert.
Following the fumble recovery, it's Wilson. A bullet throw, but incomplete. And that went off the mark a little late with the throw.
Incomplete. It's now fourth down.
Tie game, fourth quarter, and they're going for this thing on fourth down. They'll try and throw for it with Wilson. He's got Lockett. 27 yards, a big play there on fourth. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. On first down, it's Carson, and they'll get him down right around the 16.
Tackle made at the 16-yard line.
It'll be a gain of 2, and speaking of twos, it'll take us to the two-minute warning. Getting down to the good stuff, all tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports.
Push him back. Push him back. 56 is Mike. 56 is Mike. 12-14. Here we go. Check 4.
Check 50.
Switch it.
They run again with Carson. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
Brings up third down and 7.
Now Wilson. Open man is Metcalf. He's got it. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. It's a really nice 15-yard pickup, and now it's first and goal. A game-winning field goal would be a chip shot from here. Let's see how they play it on first and goal. And he is going to lose yardage here. The Chiefs now going to use the first of their timeouts, as it'll come with 36 seconds to go in half number two.
The Chiefs' one-yard line.
On the option, a handoff to Carson. And that's a touchdown as they've broken our tie here in the final minute of the fourth.
I don't know how many more of these my heart can take, my man. I just don't know. Another big touchdown late in the game. They look like they're in control, but still, there's a chance. Block the extra point, go down and score, kick the extra point themselves. They can pull this one out.
Yeah, but also on the sideline that just took the lead, you got to get your defense ready and the special teams unit for the kickoff coming up.
Yeah, you're exactly right. Got to pull everyone together and make sure they're still focused and aren't already celebrating a win.
25-yard line.
The Chiefs' offense about set to begin this drive. One possession game. Time very much a factor. How does the... Oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by DJ Reed. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line.
I tell you, Brandon, it seems like this guy's been all over...